I'm going to move on now, and we're going to hear from our incredible finalists. First of all, I want to introduce the judging team. We have some fabulous judges here today, and they have the very important task of deciding the winner. We have Professor Sergio Pilon, who's the National Coordinator of the Commission for Telemedicine Development of the Italian Ministry of Health. We have Nimrod Altman, the CEO, a member of the Board of Directors, Natali Healthcare in Israel. Henning Schneider, the Chief Information Officer of Asklepios Healthcare Group in Germany. Frederic Atzia, the Head of International Strategy Partnerships in Orange Healthcare France. And Dr. Naomi Segal, Head of the Medical Division of Maccabi Healthcare in Israel. So you have the very important task now of making sure that we select a well-deserved winner. I'm now going to start inviting our three companies up. The first up is Day 2, and I'd like to invite Amir Golan, the Chief Commercial Officer, to come and present.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Amir from Day 2, and this is an apple. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Not for everybody. I'm suffering from prediabetes, and there is a strong chances that at some point I'll be full-fledged dealing with type 2 diabetes. And when I'm going to see the doctor, the first thing they're telling me is go and see a nutritionist. And then they're trying to give me the best diet that will enable me to normalize my blood sugar level. The problem with that is diets are pretty generic, and they're not so effective as we can see. Diabetes is everywhere. So the Weizmann Institute, more than 8 years ago, decided to look at that question, what is the best diet for humans? And they didn't look just at the food, they also looked at the people that are actually using it. So this is a story about nutrition, about diabetes, about microbiome, about personalized nutrition. They build an algorithm, as you can see here. The algorithm taking a lot of data, because if we want to provide people with personalized nutrition, the first question will be, I need to know you, so give me some data about yourself. So they're taking data about the microbiome, so Day 2 today, conducting a full shotgun sequencing to understand the composition of the gut bacteria within our body. They took some blood tests and continuous glucose monitoring data, some questionnaire about lifestyle, about average behavior, and some personal information together with some food diary. Once we understand the profile of a person, what we can do, we're taking the algorithm that originally developed at the Weizmann Institute, recently was also validated by the Mayo Clinic, and we run the entire profile and the data within the algorithm. What's the result? The result is an app. Day 2 app. They're telling me as a patient, what can I eat? What will spike my blood sugar level? What will keep it down? And more important, what combination should I use in order to level it down the spikes? So this apple, for me, it's not good. It's spiking my blood sugar level. But if I add a few almonds next to it, I'm totally fine. So I can eat great meals, enjoying life, and keep my blood level low. So Day 2, why Day 2 is here? Because diabetes is everywhere, and we need to find better solution to treat it. And the microbiome bringing a lot of promise, and this is the first time we can actually use it in a predictive way in order to bring people personalized diet that will normalize their blood sugar level. We already have tens of thousands of clients that are using us, enjoying eating great, normalize the blood sugar level, and we're here because we're looking for partners that will take it to many, many different places and enable more and more people to enjoy healthier life. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Next up is Eni Field, and I'd like to invite Ofer Ramayan, founder and CEO, to come to the stage and present.
Thank you very much. Ofer Rachamim is my name, close enough though. And as she said, I'm the CEO of Eni Field Diagnostics, and I'm here to talk to you about lung function testing. I'm really excited to be here, literally having a hard time right now, but I think I'll get over it. And I'm also really excited because I have 3 minutes to explain to you why our technology is going to have a profound effect on healthcare. And the reason for that is two major diseases that affect people. One is asthma, which I'm sure everyone's familiar with. And how many in the crowd are familiar with COPD? Not very many hands, but would it surprise you to find out that COPD is the third cause of death from illness in the modern world? And that about 330 million people suffer from COPD, and that it has no permanent cure. If you, God forbid, have COPD, then you're stuck with it. And the only way to take care of your COPD is to manage it correctly and avoid exacerbations and frequent visits to the ER. Now, in order to diagnose and monitor COPD or asthma, you have to go through a certain breathing test. It's called a spirometry test. That's the most common test. And during a spirometry test, what you're required to do is exhale as forcefully as you can for about 6 seconds and expel as much air as you possibly can from the lungs. This test is pretty difficult to perform, and you can absolutely not do it at home by yourself. It requires a technician, and according to papers published by the ATS, 4 out of 10 tests are disqualified because of lack of cooperation or some sort of other technical problem. The issue is that the accuracy of the test is directly correlated to the cooperation of the patient. So we at Anyfield, we've developed a test that doesn't require any cooperation. It doesn't require any forced breathing maneuvers. You just breathe normally, like all of you are breathing right now. Okay? So you can do it in a coma. You can do the test literally while sleeping. We have separated the accuracy of the test from the testee's cooperation. We can also test children, very ill patients who can't perform the test right now, and children as well. Children of all ages, from neonates to age 6, which don't exist right now. What you see up is a graph of a test we've done, and we're showing correlation between an invasive method of measuring the pressure inside the lung and compared to our method, and the correlation speaks for itself. We have proven results that our method works, and we are right now testing on animals. We are going for a handheld device meant for home monitoring to avoid hospitalizations and exacerbations of mainly COPD, but also asthma. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much. And last, but very much not least, Omar Weisberger, Clinical Insights Leader in CSM for VR Health.
Hi, my name is Omar, and I'm a physical therapist and the Clinical Insights Leader of VR Health. We build medical virtual reality software. Basically, what we do is build virtual training rooms for cognitive, motor, and mental purposes. By controlling any aspect of the virtual experience, we enable to answer many, many medical needs through fun and engaging experiences. Our products are FDA approved and CE approved, and we are we are the first company in the world that is certified for FDA medical immersive virtual reality company in the world. In the next 3 years, VR Health is going to impact millions of lives around the world. And it's not a faraway dream. We are actually doing it today. In Soroka Hospital, in south of Israel, clinicians use our softwares for patients with stroke, brain injuries, psychiatric disorders, anxiety reduction, and many more. In Beth Israel Hospital in Boston, surgeons use our products as a replacement for anesthetics during surgical procedures. In Asafa Rofe Hospital, which is not far away from here, neuropsychologists use our software on an average of 52 times per day. A clinical study that used one of our products called Luna proved that hot flashes can be reduced in 50% by using our software. The next generation of immersive computing enables anyone with VR glasses and an internet to perform anywhere, anytime, medical procedures. Lastly, I'm proud to announce that in a month from now, we are going to launch a collaboration with Facebook in order to open the door for millions of more users to enjoy the great advantages of virtual reality in healthcare. You are more than welcome to try it out yourself at our booth. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Judges, you now have the very difficult task of selecting a winner out of those three. We're going to take just a couple of minutes. We're going to select a winner, and we'll be right back. The winner is VR Health. Congratulations. That's fantastic. And we didn't even get to try it. You hold that. Congratulations once again. And I can just tell the other two of you, it was really, really close. So certainly you've all done a fantastic job.